This is a very rare acoustic version of John Mayer's The Wheel. So let's look at the intro. And before we start that, I want to talk about a coordinate system I'm going to use when describing where the fingers are going to be going. I call it the bingo technique. And what that is, if I say G3, I mean the third fret of the open G string. So you got to know your strings and their open note values. So this is the low E, the A, the D, the G, the B, and the E. High E. So that's your high E, that's your low E. So if I go E3 and I'm on the high E, then that's the third fret of the high E, that kind of thing. So if you don't know the notes of the open strings, go learn them. It'll only benefit you later on. So let's look at this song. It starts off with a D minor in the intro part, and then it transitions into an F sus 2, both down at the root. And the intro sounds like this. So there's a lot of little jazzy licks. We see the traditional slapping. A lot of leading notes. A lot of low notes preceding chords going into the beginning of the measure. That is the intro. After that, we have a verse A, which is a subdued version of the intro. Simplified, because he's singing over it. After which, we go into what I'm calling a verse B. Now, normally, this would be almost like a pre-chorus in any other song, but this is what it sounds like. So the lyrics change every time. It often doesn't come before the chorus, so I'm calling that verse B. It's a very different verse idea, but it's still part of the verse, and that can be found happening on the root of the E6 and then E3 for the G part. After that, we go into a chorus. Now, the chorus is played a couple different ways. The very first time we hear it, there's a lot of slapping and whacking and thwacking. Afterwards, later on in the song, it comes into a more driving kind of way. That we have a solo, which is really cool. I'll outline that in its entirety. Coming off the solo, we have a bridge. And then some of the other parts repeat, and then the outro of the song is kind of a modified chorus, but the changes are different. So that is pretty much the parts of the song. Every single measure in this song is different. So if you want, you can just take a couple generic measures and make that your repeatable part, and we'll go from there. So I'm not going to show you a simplified version of the song, but I may show you parts that are easily repeatable, because there's probably no need to do it as exactly as you hear it on the track. Intros, measures 1 to 8. Luckily, this song is played entirely with the fingers, so we don't have to pick anywhere. Let's take measures 1 and 2, and we'll loop them so we get the groove down. So right off the top, we have slaps on beats 2 and 4. We have some slap flicks. Slap flick is where you're slapping, and at the same time your index finger pops out and strikes notes at the same time. So you have a slap and a note sounding at the same time. That's throughout the piece. And we have pickup notes preceding a lot of the chords. And let's take a look at measure 1. Let's play it slow a couple times. So we have two chords in there. We have a D minor. I fret that with my first finger on E1, third finger on B3, second finger on G2, and then the open D. Speaking of open D, there's a pickup measure in this song. So the very first note we hear in it is the open D, and that's not even in measure 1. Measure 1 starts with the second time we play the open D, but this time it's with a chord. So we have a slap. And then this F sus 2 chord. So the F sus 2 chord I fret with my thumb on the E1, my third finger on D3, G string is open, and then first finger on B1. So from the top, we end off with this F note here. So just like that, open D was a pickup note to the chord in the next measure. This low F starts off an arpeggio. So the beginning of measure two is actually, but its beginning root note started in the last measure as the last note. So it really is like this. But when you're looking at the music, it starts. So let's look at the slaps and the flicks in there. So we arpeggiate it. Then we come down with a slap flick. And we're hitting the note at G2, which is an A. Two low Fs here. Then we have an open G. And then our second flick in the measure. Actually, that flick is hitting the open G as well. And then going back to the open D. So measure two slow. One more time, from the top, measures one and two slow. One more time. Measure three is exactly like measure one. But measure four has us starting in on these really cool licks based in around that F sus 2 chord. And measure four sounds like this. One more time. There's a slap flick in there. Right here. We're going for this note here, D3. Usually we're ending off on this F, which is weird because you would think to keep the pattern up, he'd end on a D. So what happens in measure 5 now is he's got to throw that open D in at the start of measure 5 and it's rushed. So it sounds like that. Let's take measures 1 to 5 to show you what that means slow. See how measure 5 was rushed? Measure 6, 7, and 8. So measure 6 has a neat lick. Oops. It ends off with an open G and open D. And then the familiar D minor. Actually, the end of that one, measure 7, has a flick. Before ending off with a measure 8. So let's try measures 1 to 8 really slow. Is the intro. People have the right to fly. Measures 9 to 16 are verse 1a, and they are a stripped down version of the stuff we heard in the intro because he's singing over it. This is the lyric that starts off with And for the most part, pretty straightforward. Something neat happens in the last measure that we can get into. So let's blow past the first ones because we've seen it already. We've seen this D minor, this is measure 9. D minor to F sus 2. After that, measure 10. Very stripped down, hardly any notes in that one. Although I am slapping on the D string because the next note I play is the open D. We get to measure 11. Same thing with that D minor again. And then measure 12 has a neat little lick. This is the part where he throws in the wacky licks most of the time. And that sounds like this. What we're doing is we're taking that F sus 2, stringing it in an F major. With our second finger, we're fretting the G2 here, which is an A. So start that off, fret it like an A major, and do this. So we're hitting one string and then two strings together. And as we come down for our slap flick, we're doing a pull-off from B1 to the open B. So slow the first little bit. One more time. Then we're doing an octave thing. Low F, high F. So let's try measure 12 slow one more time. One more time. It gives it a really weird ring. So one more time from the top. Measures 9 to 12. Measures 13 to 16. So one thing about that is that last slap, there's no pickup note, and we'll get to that in a second. So again, measure 13, it's the D minor thing. Afterwards, we have something similar we've seen before in measure 14. Slightly modified. So again, at measure 14. One more time. And then we go to measure 15. And then we have that arpeggiated thing to end it off. And then a very long slap. So the arpeggiated thing in this instance, and it's important to get the timing of that right. Like the other arpeggio before it, it starts with the last note of the last measure, leading into the arpeggio part. And then a very long slap. So one more time from the top, measures 13 to 16. And the reason the slap in this case is so low is we're going to be doing a major position shift up to the E6. Let's move it along. Measure 17 to 20 is what I'm calling verse B. It's not really a pre-chorus, not really a post-chorus. It's kind of versey in my opinion, but it's thrown in all over the place. It's a weird John Mayer thing. It sounds like this. So we're up on the 6th fret of the low E. I fret this with my thumb, and then my 2nd finger is on B6, my 3rd finger is on G7, 1st finger is on G5, and wait for the descending part here. And at measure 17 sounds like this. One more time slow. So you hear a little descending, or the beginnings of a descending lick. And we have a slap flick in there. So we pluck these two notes on the outside together. Come down with our slap flick. And we're sounding G7 here. And then we arpeggiate. And then our slap flick, sounding B6. So together. off with a low bass note. Afterwards, in measure 18, we continue that descending arpeggio with our quick, and it's a rushed arpeggio. You get these sometimes in these measures. And that's how 18, let's do 18 from the top because I kind of rushed it there. And a long slap. Let's do measures 17 and 18 together slow. And when there's a long slap with no pickup note, it usually means a position change. In this case, we're sliding down to G, and that part sounds like this. One more time. This is measures 19 and 20. And measure 19 slow. Slap flick with a hole with two notes here. It's arranged nicely with the slaps and the low notes in between. So you're either doing a slap or a low note, and your thumb is always in the right place. And you're pulling up with your fingers, slapping with your thumb, or fretting low notes with your thumb, and pulling up with your fingers. So it's nicely organized. Let's do the whole thing, measure 17 to 20 slow. So that's a really nice bit. Later on, the descending arpeggio goes down to a D5. So it starts at D8, D7, D5, all with the same bottom notes. Kind of like that. But in the first time we hear it, it goes back up. Like that. Verses 21 to 24 get us out of verse 1, and there's a couple of interesting things worth showing. Let's do it slow. Let's look at that. Right off the top, that D minor chord, this is different. Instead of hitting that chord all four strings, plucking, we're hitting the top three, these, and then coming back to the bass note right after. So it's slap, like that. That's measure 21. Going into measure 22, we have this. And there we're playing around with making that F sus2 an F major by adding on this G2 A note. So measure 22 is like this. And then that measures 23. Straightforward D minor. When I went into the last measure, measure 24. The lick in measure 24 is like this. Time, measure 24. One more time from the top, measures 21 to 24. The 28 are the beginnings of verse 2a. We'll just go through them twice slow. And again, we have a long pause because we're going to immediately transition into another position on the string. Let's do that one more time slow. Measures 29 to 36 are verse 2b. Let's go through that. There's a lot of minor variations. Mm-hmm. at the very end of that measure, measure 36, we have a slap and an open A, which leads us into the chorus. So let's look at the beginning measures, 29. Well, the major variation I find are... We're not going up high to that note anymore. It's just... We're just staying on this... highest note we get is the G5. It's... One more time, measure 29. And then measure 30. End off with an open E string to transition into the next position, which is down on the G position, 3rd fret, E3. Again with an open E, we do that first part again.
And that's the way this wheel keeps working out. That's the way.
Measures 37 to 44 are the chorus, and there's a lot of whack, smack, thunk, slap stuff going on. So essentially it's like this. Kind of stuff going. So we have an F power chord, the octaves, and the fifth. So that is first finger on A8, third finger barring D10 and G10. And that's all we're really plucking. Later on near the end of the song, he ventures down to the B10 area to give it a higher ring, but for the first two choruses, he's just sounding these three notes. And we do this. It's measure 37. We let it hang out there for quite a while. Then we do a down stroke muted, an up stroke muted, slap with the thumb, and then open string to transition to the next chord. So let's show how measure 37 goes into 38. That's measure 37, 38. So one more time on this. Once you got that down, you got the whole thing. Down, muted, up muted, slap, open string, or fretted string, depending on where you are. So 37 one more time. Then we're going into 38. Our root note changes to E10, and I use my second finger to fret that. Same thing. Then we go to E8. Changes up a bit. We don't have a muted strum, down strum. We just have a slap and an open E. And we go down to our lowest note at E6. That's the lowest we're going to go. And that changes up a bit. We just have a downstroke strum. And then we have a slap on the A string and the open A before we start all over again. For the whole measure, and then we go, and then we go into the next part. So one more time slow, the chorus measures 37 to 44. So it's important to have these descending notes. Like that in the middle of this kind of descending chord thing. Later on, the other chorus is played differently. It's more driving. It's... But the first time the chorus is played, we have these whack, thunk, slap things. Lots of fun. Following the chorus, we go immediately into another verse B part. 49 to 52 introduce some nice new riffs. It was measure 50 with the riff in it. It's D minor again. We do an octave in measure 51, the low F and the high F. And then we do this crazy thing. So we've got that F sus2 chord, but we're just concentrating on these three notes from the D string D3 to the B1. We're plucking all three strings. And ending off with an open A. And then there's a rush D that starts the next measure. So let's do that slow from the top, measures 49 to 52. Just use my thumb and first two fingers. Very last, near the end of that sequence, you do a single D3 and then a slap lick before doing the open A. And then the very next measure, measure 53, we're starting with an open D. Like that. Measures 53 to 56 are leading us back into verse 3. We have a couple neat things. I'll just play through it slow. Note that 56 ends on an F. Not many times you go from that low F to the D minor, but this is one of them. So 53 features a rushed open D string into the D minor. And another one of these F sus 2s where you grab the high part of the chord and then follow up with the low part before going into the slap and then the last lead in note. So I'll just do measure 53 slow. It's a subtle thing, but it's there. And then 54 has a nice riff in it. We're doing an F chord here. We open it up with the F sus2 for the slap flick. And almost a double open D. Once with the flick and then once with the thumb. Leading into the D minor again. Finally, measure 56. So one more time, slow, measures 53 to 56. Measures 57 to 64 are verse 3a, and the only major difference here is he's hanging on to that second F sus2 a bit longer, like this. That kind of thing. So just hang on to it a bit longer. Not much more difference than that. Then after that, measures 65 and 68, we go into the verse B part. Seen it all before. The only thing I'd say is the verse B part on the slap flick, we're actually hitting the G5 as much as we can. That's the only real difference there. And after that, we go into the chorus. We end off on an open A, so I'll just do that last measure. 68. We do that open A. And that's the way this wind keeps working out. That's the way. Measure 69 to 80 are the second chorus, and this is a more driving version of it, where you're hanging on the chords longer. And what we're doing is it's kind of a pluck, slap, pluck, down strum, up strum sometimes, slap, open string, transition to the next thing. I'll just loop this rhythm a bit. So some chords are like that. This F chord is almost always like that. That's at A8, and then our third finger is barring D10 and G10. But the later chords are usually only two. Either just the bass note. I just hit the E10 there. Or pluck and a strum. So just pitch into the tab and you can kind of get which ones you hang on longer. So let's just do that from the top, measure 69 to 80. So this is just before we go into the pre-chorus again, we tack that on the end of that chorus. And we hold that and we do a slap and a D minor to go into the D minor thing again later. So a couple other things about this part. Just when you're coming out of it for the second time, the part where you're on E8, it kind of goes like this. So he does 2, 2, 2, and then 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. And then we go into this part. Not much more to say about that. It's a nice change from the... And be careful about the leading notes. They're exactly the same as in the last chorus. Measures 81 to 84 are just before the solo. We'll go through them slow. Ending off an open E, low E. So the first bit is straightforward enough. That slap flick is almost the full strum of the chord, like thwacked to sound. In measure 81. Going into measure 82, we repeat the low F that we ended on the previous measure. One more time, measure 82. Open D for the next measure. Again, that's one of those measures, measure 83, with the bottom part of the F sus 2. Then the top part of the F sus 2, and then the root note following slap, and then back to the root note. And then measure 84 has this two note chords coming down. So those two note chords are played with my second finger on B6, third finger on G7, and then we have our first finger on G5 with our second finger on B6 still. We sound that. Then our pinky reaches up to D8, and we sound that one along with the G5. And then we come down with our third finger to D7. So. And then the open string one more time. Measures 85 to 92 are the solo, and like most Delmare solos, it's a thing of beauty. Bass notes, passing tones, beautiful movements. Let's look into it. We'll go through it slow-mo instead of me trying to explain everything. So we're starting off with position E6 here with our thumb. my first finger is barring D5 and G5, with my second finger on B6. And that's one position we work off. And from that position, we have all these notes. And then the next position is a G position. We're on E3 here with our thumb. We've seen this in the chorus, in the verse B. So it's familiar territory for us, but some new ground still, and there's a lot of barring going on, and we just kind of hit all the extra notes with our fingers that aren't doing the barring. Pay close attention to the rhythmic clues in it, like the... And all the notes fit in place in and around these slaps on 2 and 4. So let's do it really slow to start this time. Just keep working on the tab until you've got everything straightened away. Once you get going with it, plays itself, but the tab will be a big help in you getting this under your belt. Measures 93 to 100 are a bridge coming off the solo, and it features four chords. We have this one here, which I have no idea what it's called. I'm not going to even look it up. The bottom half of a F major. We have a D and the F sus 2. And it's played in this rhythm. So there's always two of these. A slap and then... at that F sus 2. Now keep in mind, measure 92 ended off with, so measure 93 that starts us all off, we'll start a bit differently. We're halfway into it. So let's just run through all that slow. Measure 93 to 100. We should go over the ending because it's slightly different than the other rhythms. The ending is like this. And then he starts into a singing part. You can just do this. Do the whole thing. If you're like me, you have the urge to slap in places where he doesn't, like... But make it your own, but for the most part, that's what it is. Sometimes we're having an open E and then fretting the F for this chord. Sometimes it's already pre-fretted and it's just double picked, double plucked. Have fun with that part.
See, you can find if you ever want to get right.
Measures 101 to 104 are verse 4A, and they're pretty jazzy. They sound like this. And they end off with a muted, open, low E string. So the first time he goes to do that D minor chord, he misses everything but the first top two strings, the E1 and the B3. So that's something nice to throw in. And the other main difference is he's shortening up a lot of these F sus 2 chords. So the first one he plays is long. Everything after that is shortened. So let's play that slow once through measures 101 to 104. Here's the short chords. And that's nice too, measure 104. After the slap, we have this. And that is where we pull the whole chord, pluck everything. Then we hit the low F, and then we grab the top end of it and go into the slap near the end of the measure. From measures 105 to 120, he's into the verse 4 B part, and he's going basically between those two positions. Get away with it quite easily. He does a couple things that are interesting. Sometimes he throws in up at the high part at the 6th fret here, these two note things. So he's pulling up on notes, the note B6 and G5. And the very first time he goes into that, I'm not sure what measure he throws this in at, but instead of going, he goes, and you actually hear this note here, a G5 and a B5 from that initial two note thing here. And on the descending part, he's doing these, he's plucking these two notes here all the way down. And he does a couple other interesting things, but for the most part, just keep it simple and do the part that you've become familiar with. He's doing. And then at the very end of that, you let that ring because we're going into chorus number 3.
And that's the way that this wheel keeps working out. That's the way.
Measures 121 to 128 are the final chorus. And what we hear is a mixture of what we heard in chorus 1 and chorus 2. Chorus 3 starts off with, it has that muted strumming and whack thunking, but right after that first measure, the F chord, everything else is from chorus 2. And the only difference really is that we're including some higher notes on the B string, so we're taking that power chord and we're making it go one string down the B and hitting the 10th fret, so B10 there. And one thing, the ending of the chorus is a bit different, so let's look at measures 127 to 129. I'll look at measure 128, which is the last measure of that last chorus, because it's got a bit of a timing shift. So coming out of measure 127, we have this. So I'll explain that. So 128 sounds like this. It's just a neat timing thing he throws in right at the end of the chorus. So let's take that again at measure 127. Then we do this. And then we're into the outro. So what we're doing there is we're fretting that thing with the, that chord with the root on the E6, and then I've got my second finger on A8, and then with my pinky, I'm barring D10, G10, and B10. And I'm going to be alternating the pressure, because that's a lot to hold down and clamp onto. So heading into measure 128, we do this. And that only uses the lowest string, and then the three strings under that. Then I shift everything down a string, and I start taking up the B string, the G string, and the D string before hitting the open A to transition to the outro. So one more time, coming out of measure 127. It's hard to understand in the context, but if you listen to the original track, you'll hear what I mean.
You can't have too much fun part of the wheel now. You can't have too much fun part of it.
Measures 129 to 156 are the outro, ending of the song. The chords are similar to that of the chorus, but the order is changed. We now do this. We hit this E6 root quicker, and then come back up to the F to recycle everything over again. And the rhythm is like this. We'll take a bite-sized chunk to 129 to measures 135. And this chord here, where the E6 is this. And later on, we're going high, introducing notes on that B string again, B10, etc., similar to the very last chorus. So one more time, measures 129 to 135. So 136 has an interesting lick in it, and coming off of 135, 136 pauses, and then it starts off like this. And then goes into the next measure. So that chord we're doing right off the top, so first in 136 there's a rest, a little bit of a pause. The chord we're doing is D10, G9, and B11. We pluck it once, we slap it, and I'm slapping on the fifth string. Then I'm barring my second finger across D10 and G10, and I keep my third finger on B11. I do one thumb note on D10, pluck the whole thing again, and then I do this. The flick is actually sounding the 13th fret of the B string, B13, and I'm fretting it with my pinky. So we're doing this. And then I am hitting the open A to go back into the rest of the outro. So one more time. It's hard to get the timing coming off of that last chorus. And then measures 137 all the way to the end are just the same chords we've been repeating, slightly different rhythms, but we're making them sound high with the addition of the notes on the B string. So there. And then we do this. We're beating the chords out there. And then he just kind of lets the chords trail off. He stops playing them at some point and does the rest of the song a cappella. And that's pretty much it. It was a great song. I'm really glad someone showed this to me. Someone sent me an email and said, check this version out. You got to do it. And it stuck in my ear like an earworm, and I had to tap it out. So I hope you enjoy it. It's pretty obscure. He doesn't do this song a lot on acoustic, but I'm glad he did this one time. Catch you guys later.
My life is gonna see the love I give return to me.